Can you hear my voice? Yes, everyone. How are you all? Aiza, Iman, Iman Hassan, Miram. Yes, Zahida Fatima, Omar bin Salman, Hamdan. How are you all, beta? Can you hear my voice? Can you hear my voice and see my screen? Please let me know so that we will start the lesson today. Yes, means everything is clear, the screen and the voice board. Please let me know, everyone. Quickly write down if. Yes, but not properly. Just a minute.
What about now? Now? Tell me now. Is it clear now? Yes, okay. Okay, so let's start the lesson. Today we are going to reinforce chapter compounds or mixture. Okay. Today our today's lesson is the reinforcement of chapter compounds or mixture. As you have already learned this chapter thoroughly, today I'm just recapping the important points from this chapter. Okay. Yes, okay, Aiza, thank you. So, as we know that the everything around us is made up of matter, and matter is divided into two parts, pure substances and mixtures. Pure substances are all those which are elements and which after chemical reaction form compounds. All those substances which we find in periodic table are elements. Everything around us is matter, and matter is made up of elements. Okay, elements are the pure substances like oxygen, hydrogen, iron, carbon, nitrogen, sulfur, sodium. They are all pure substances, and we find them in the periodic table. When they, two or more elements undergo chemical reaction, when two or more elements undergo chemical reaction, they form compounds like water, like table salt, ammonia, sugar, magnesium oxide, or there are so many things in our daily life we use them, they are compounds. Okay, so pure substances are elements and compounds. Matter, we start from matter. Matter is divided into two types of substances, pure substances and mixtures. Pure substances are elements and compounds. However, mixtures, they are not pure substances. They are formed without any chemical reaction, and they are salt water. If we mix two different compounds like water and table salt, it becomes a mixture without any chemical reaction. They both combine, they both join together without any chemical reaction and form mixture. Like salt water, like our mouthwashes, alloys, or pizza, Italian salad dressing, solid waste dump, or so many things in our surrounding we use, they are mixtures. Means most of them are compounds and most of them are mixtures. Okay, so we can define compounds as pure substances and mixtures as impure substances. Okay, but they all form matter. Next is, what is a compound? So a compound is a substance formed when two or more chemical elements are chemically combined together. Means every element which we find in the periodic table, when they undergo a chemical reaction, they join together chemically. Means after a chemical reaction, they form a substance, a new substance that is called compound. So here are the examples of compounds like ammonium chloride, like sugar, like table salt, means sodium metal and chlorine gas both have different states of matter, like sodium is solid and chlorine is gas. Both are in different states, but when they are when they join together, when they undergo a chemical reaction, they form a totally new substance that is called table salt. If I ask you to reverse them or get the chlorine gas or sodium metal back together, it's not possible, right? Once the table salt is formed after a chemical reaction of sodium metal and chlorine gas, we cannot revert them. We cannot separate them because a totally new substance is formed. Likewise, hydrogen gas and oxygen gas, both are gases. Look, they are kept in the gas cylinders. When they join together chemically, they form a totally new substance that is called water. Both initially, before the chemical reaction, both are gases. After a chemical reaction, a new thing that is formed is in the liquid form. Got it? Okay, now next is properties of compound. Elements to compounds means elements undergo a chemical reaction and elements combine chemically to form compounds. So here in this picture, they are showing us the sodium metal. So in the solid state, again, the chlorine gas, yellowish green, poisonous gas. If we inhale that gas, it's poisonous. It is not good for our health. It creates poisonous effect in our body. So when they react together, when they undergo a chemical reaction, they form a totally new substance that is called salt, okay, which is good for our health, which we eat on daily basis for tasting our food, okay. So the properties which are earlier, the elements which have the properties earlier, they are totally forgotten, they are totally changed after the chemical reaction. For instance, over here, compounds can be broken down by chemical method. If we want to separate the table salt, it cannot be separated back into chlorine gas and sodium metal. Rather, if we pass any electric current or something, some other method, chemical method can be applied, they can be broken down, the compounds can be broken down into something simple and new substance. Okay, compounds are formed by chemical reaction. So when we want to form a compound by a chemical reaction, we always have to follow the chemical reaction, and after the chemical reaction we get heat and light. Okay, during the chemical reaction we always get heat and light exchange within the surrounding. Okay, like burning of fire, you can see burning of fire, a chemical reaction is taking place during the burning of fire. See the smoke, carbon dioxide gas is given out. Carbon, the coal or wood contains carbon and oxygen is present in the surrounding. But when they combine together, burn together, chemical reaction takes place and what we get? Carbon dioxide gas. And along with the carbon dioxide gas, we get heat and light as well. So it is a rule that during the chemical reaction, heat or light, or at times both, are exchanged with the surrounding, means given out or taken in. Okay. Next is different elements in compounds are joined together in a fixed proportion by mass. Means if we want to carry out some chemical reaction, we have to join the elements in a fixed proportion. We have to take the elements which are taking part in the chemical reaction, they should be in a particular measurement. They should be in a fixed proportion of mass. Okay. Next is mixtures. A mixture consists of two or more substances which are not joined together chemically. Means when mixtures are formed, we should not follow any chemical reaction. And mixtures may consist of elements, compounds, or both. Right? Means when we are going to make mixtures, there is no chemical reaction takes place. There is no proportion of fixed mass. There is no heat or light given out or taken in. And when we are joining the mixtures, elements can also be taken, compounds can also be combined, or at times elements or compounds both are mixed together without any chemical reaction. Like here, lemon squash, we are going to make the lemon squash, it's a mixture. We should take lemon, sugar, and water. We mix them together without any chemical reaction. No chemical reaction takes place. We just dissolve the sugar and squeeze the lemon in the water quickly so that lemon squash is ready. And no chemical reaction, no light is given out, no heat is given out, right? I believe that every one of you have in your life made at time tank syrup or some other drinks like lemon squash or different types of juices, okay, at home. So you must have experienced that when we dissolve the sugar in water, only we need to stir them thoroughly so that sugar is dissolved in water thoroughly, and squeeze the lemon or put some other juices or something like that. But no chemical reaction takes place, no heat is given out or taken in, no light is given out or taken in. Okay, next is substances which make up the mixtures may be solid, liquid or gas. Like here, sugar is solid, water is liquid, the juice, lemon juice is semi-solid, means some pulp of the lemon particles, fibers are also there, and liquid is also there. Now next is mixtures. Again, a compound is a chemical combination of its constituent. A mixture is a physical combination of its constituent. Means compounds are formed by chemically. Two or more substances or two or more elements combine chemically in mixture. Two or more substances or elements or compounds, they are joined together without any chemical reaction, only physically. Means if we want to separate them together, the mixture, we can separate them. Like compounds, chemical combination of its constituents, there is a bond formed. This shows the chemical reaction has taken place. This bond between the particles, it shows that the chemical reaction has taken place. However, in mixture, you can see there is no bonding. Only the particles, they are joined physically in a beaker or in any container, but there is no bond. It shows that there is no chemical reaction taking place, right? Next is some useful mixtures. Now, air. We know that air is a gaseous element. Can anybody name the gases which are present in the air? Start writing the name of gases which are present in the air. Yes, hurry up, beta. Yes, Varda, Sohema, Umar, Nida, Fatma. Mahad, yes, Hadika, Iman, Umar bin Salman, Yusera. Beta, start writing the names of gases which are present in the air. Yes, Hania, yes, good. Hania, any more gases? Miram, right. Miram, write down one more name. At least there should be three names from everyone. Three names from everyone. Yes, Iman, good. Yes, excellent, Mahad. By the way, Mahad, why were you not coming to school? The revision is going on. All of you should attend the classes regularly, okay? Yusera, yes, good. Noble gases. Nitrogen, yes, Hamza. Nitrogen, two more gases. Names of two more gases. Yes, Varda, good. So we see that there are four or five different types of different gases. They are joined together without any chemical reaction to form air. So we can say that air is a mixture of different gases. Air is a mixture of different gases. If in the exam it comes that air is a mixture of dash gases, so you can write down air is a mixture of gaseous elements or different gases, okay? Whatever the gases which are formed, they are all elements, okay? Elements and compounds, like carbon dioxide is a compound, nitrogen is an element, oxygen is an element, hydrogen is an element, noble gases are elements, so they are all the gaseous elements, okay, so we can say that air is a mixture of gaseous elements. Now mineral water, write down the reason why mineral water is a mixture, not a compound. Write down the reason why mineral water Yes.
Hello.
Yes, class. Mineral water is a mixture of mineral and water, right? Mineral water is a mixture of mineral and water. Good, good, everyone. Excellent. Excellent, everyone. Right. So, if in exam it comes that why mineral water is a mixture, like we have revised it in the, we will revise it in the class, that why mineral water is a mixture, if water is a compound, but mineral water is a mixture because it's a mixture of mineral and water. Okay, or you can also write answer because in water different minerals are added or mixed. Because in water different minerals are added or mixed. This should also be your answer. Okay. Now, next is aircraft bodies. Aircraft bodies are made up of which substance? Name the substance which is a mixture. Write down the name of the substance which is a mixture of different elements. It is light and strong. Write down the name of that substance. Yes. Yes, good. You, Sarah. Excellent, 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 everyone. Duralumin. So if in exams it comes, define duralumin. How would you define it? Write down the definition of duralumin. Write down the definition of duralumin. By the time I will be marking your attendance. Start writing the definition of duralumin. Duralumin, it is light and strong, and it is a mixture of different elements. In aluminium, aluminium, different elements are mixed to form alloy called duralumin. Duralumin, it is light. This is the property of duralumin. Okay, it is light and strong. Yes, Hamdan, good. Yes, that's why it is used for making the aircraft bodies. Right. Next is food. So, food is also the ingredients which we take are the compounds. For making the food, the ingredients which we use are compounds like sugar, like salt, like we take carbohydrate, fats, proteins, oil, ghee, butter, cheese, or different vegetables, meat. They are all compounds. Carbohydrates, compounds. In compounds, we take example of carbohydrates. Carbohydrate is a compound. Fat is a compound. Proteins are compound. They are all mixed together to form our food, and our food is a mixture of different compounds. Okay, but when we cook them, after cooking it becomes a compound. Before cooking, like for instance, we are making fruit salad, we are making vegetable salad, they are all mixture. We take cucumber, we take some boiled potatoes, we add some salad leaves, or we mix tomatoes, different substances, different fruits, when they are mixed without any cooking, it's a mixture. But after a cooking, if we cook them together, cooking takes the chemical reaction, because cooking or baking is the process of chemical reaction, right? So next is our, you can see here, this person is mixing the flour for making cookies or for making some cakes or something like that. He is mixing the different substances like flour, sugar, butter. Different substances are mixed together. There is no heat is taking place. There is no light or heat is given out or taken in. So what is the formation going on? Formation of mixture. Here in this picture, you can see in the test tube, during the chemical reaction, heat and light is given out. This shows that chemical reaction is taking place. Okay, something new is being formed. Right, next is differences between compounds and mixture. Now the first difference is that no chemical reaction takes place during the formation of mixture. Clear? Compounds are formed by chemical reaction, which usually involves an exchange of energy in the form of heat, light, or both. Clear, everyone? I think there is no ambiguity. Everything is very clear that during the formation of compound, heat and light, chemical reaction takes place, and heat and light are exchanged. However, during the formation of mixture, no heat or light is take it in or given out, and no chemical reaction takes place. Next difference is the properties of mixture are the properties of the substances that make up the mixture. Properties of a mixture are the properties of a substance that make up the mixture, right? Means when we mix different substances in a bowl, like if we want to make the cake better or cookies better, we add different substances, and the properties of the substances are not lost, okay, when we make the mixture. However, in making the compound, the properties of the constituent elements, means the substances which are going to mix together to undergo a chemical reaction, the elements which are joining together chemically, they lose their original properties, and something new they get. Something new is formed. Next is differences between mixture and compound, that it can be separated into its components by physical method. Like we evaporate, if we want to separate the salt water, we will leave the salt water under the sun, or we will put them on the fire so that the water evaporates and it leaves behind the salt. Likewise, filtration and distillation, these evaporation, filtration, distillation, these are the methods of separating the mixture back into their constituent substances. However, compounds can only be broken down into simpler substances by chemical methods such as decomposition. Means if we burn the sugar or we heat the sugar molecules cannot be returned back into carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. Rather, they turn into something new and very simple. They can be broken down. Okay. Next is the substances in the mixture. Yes, class, we were discussing about the Yes, beta, there is some distortion due to the electric power cut. There is electricity failure. That's why I got disconnected. Okay. Okay, I believe that the points we have just discussed before the disconnection were all clear. Okay, so this we have discussed. Now next is, yes, this point we were discussing, that for making the substances in the for making this mixture, the substances can be mixed in any proportion by mass. Means for making the mixture, we should not we should not take the exact proportion of the substances. However, for chemical reaction, elements are always joined in a fixed proportion by mass. Next is, now the reinforcement questions. The reinforcement questions. Okay. Somebody new has joined us. Let me mark the attendance. Yes, Abdullah, you have recently joined. Am I correct? Okay. So now this is the question answer session. Why sugar and salt are considered as compound? Start writing the answers. Yes, beta, start writing the answers. Why sugar and salt are considered as compound? And by the way, please be careful that just after the class, as soon as the class will end, you will be getting the quiz, reinforcement quiz of this chapter. Okay, Abdullah, no issue. Start writing the answers. Why sugar and salts are considered as compound? Okay, Abdullah. Next question, name three ways of the formation of compounds. Three ways are, which we have learned, that when elements join together, when compounds join together, when elements or elements and compounds both join together. Okay, this question we have already discussed. Start writing the answer of question number one. Hamza, no. Hamza, because, yes, mineral water, the question for mineral water is okay. I'm asking about why sugar and salt are considered as compound. Because the answer should be, start writing it, because I'm also writing the answer. Okay, Umaima, this is okay, but now focus on question number one. Why salt and sugar are compound? Because they are formed after the chemical reaction. They are formed after the chemical reaction. Yes, Mahat, good. Next question. What is a duralumin? This we have already discussed and you people have answered me. Now leave this question. Leave question number four. Next is, name the gases which are found in the air. This we also have discussed. What are the things exchanged during the chemical reaction? Write down the answer of this question. What are the things exchanged during the chemical reaction? Name two things which are exchanged during the chemical reaction. Right, Varda. What about others? Start writing the answer of this question. And light and yes, hello. Yes, Iman, Hamza, Anjum, and Sohema. Beta, we are concluding the class now. Get ready for after 5 minutes. You will be getting the quiz. Try to attempt it, everyone. After 5 minutes, by 9 a.m., you will be getting the quiz. Is there anything you need to discuss more? Because I think we have almost discussed everything from this chapter. Okay, wish you good luck for exams, and please revise the chapter thoroughly. We will discuss the remaining portion, whatever, if you find difficult, we will discuss this in the class in the coming week. Okay, thank you. Allah Hafiz. Allah Hafiz.